Good evening, everyone. Justin, aka Pocket Ace, is coming to you today on Pocket Ace's Crypto. As you can see, really big on the screen there, we're going to talk about something called Vertec. Before we get into it, obviously, please do hit that like and subscribe button and bell and all that fun jazz. I do appreciate all the support the channel is getting and the growth that I am getting and the networking that I am doing and the people I'm meeting. I can't appreciate it all enough. So I will keep saying it because I do. So today I've got kind of a fun one. I have not done a lot of farms or a lot of DEXs and stuff like that. I do like the idea around the farms. There is a little bit of risk, or a little to a lot, depending on how you go into them. And I feel like I haven't been educated enough to go into them as much as I'd like to create some more consistent returns. But as I grow and as my income grows in the space, I want to start finding places where I can put funds that will grow organically, maybe not as fast as other things, but maybe safer, or help me grow different tokens or coins, kind of just to diversify a bit. So I've been having a little bit of a chat with the team here, and I am looking very forward to bring them onto an AMA as well. So this can kind of a two-part series, so that we can kind of do a little bit of an overview right now. I'm going to do a live deposit and put some stuff in there, and then we're going to follow it up with possibly two other videos, one about some NFTs they're launching and some other things that are coming, and then actually an AMA as well with them to go into more details as to how their roadmap is working. And at that time, I'd like to kind of understand maybe a little bit more and maybe dive deep for you guys to help all of us understand a little bit more how these work and the risks involved. But I'll try and go through some of them that I do know as we go through it. So let's start that. They got a really pretty kind of thing here. They do have a white paper kind of thing about their DEX and about some things. I definitely think there's some things to go through here. There's a little noob guide to investing in liquidity pools. Definitely something you want to learn before you get too far into. I like kind of going head first and learning as I go. At the same token, I do have some base knowledge based on some different YouTubers that I'm friends with or know of and have watched either their videos or had discussions with them on this kind of stuff. So I'm not going to go through this too much, but definitely something to have a peek at. The other neat thing is some of their partnerships that they have, of finance being one that I like to see on here. So looking forward to seeing. I think they have some liquidity pools in there that they've helped create with them. So something I may get in later on, because I do have some up tokens. And some are staked, some are not. So yeah, I got to take a look at that stuff. So getting into this, the vision: Vertec aims to revolutionize the decentralized trading market on Binance Smart Chain by utilizing Balancer 2 V2 technology to provide large swaps for stablecoins. So the big thing here is a lot of times it's liquidity. So it's getting enough tokens in there. And so I've actually over time kind of changed where I've gone based on what I've used for doing this trading or swapping based on different aspects, because sometimes their liquidity pools are not big enough to give you the best rate or to not have too much slippage, or like it just cost you money if you're not careful on where you use, and using things as simple as, for instance, MetaMask and maybe PancakeSwap, for example, oftentimes can cost you more money than you realize using those easy ways, quote unquote. So seeking things like this that might have better system set up can be very important and cost saving for you in the long run. I'm not saying this is the one yet. I'm hoping they could maybe become the one. I think they have some desires to and have some big plans to do that. But that will take time, and I'll show you a little bit when I do my deposit what I mean by that and how it affects it. So our goal is to become the leading decentralized exchange in the market. In addition to this, we plan to evolve Vertec into a comprehensive trading platform offering features such as perpetuals, derivatives, portfolio tracking, alerts, and advanced trading utilities. So some of that stuff, I am definitely, I have not seen something that does the derivatives and portfolio tracking, that kind of stuff to kind of help with trading and whatnot. So definitely curious about how that will the outcome of that, and looking forward to seeing how these guys evolve. And they also seem to be, like I said, very, very friendly, very good guys. Had some chats, and looking forward to the AMA to learn more. Our mission is to make decentralized crypto investment accessible and user-friendly, while also catering to the needs of advanced traders through our advanced trading tools. So some neat stuff down the road. Looks like works obviously on possibly an app that's coming out for them as well, or maybe is out. And so going through some different things with weighted pools, multi-tokens, so they can go up to 8 tokens for their trading pools. A lot of times they're just 2. So that creates some extra... I probably could create less risk in some cases, and possibly more depending on how you do it. hardcore math to ensure price stability regardless of liquidity. So that's kind of neat. If they don't need as much liquidity to create some good stable price points where your slippage doesn't get affected as much, then that could be quite an advantageous thing if they've got some ways to do that that are more unique than other protocols that do the same kind of thing. Custom pools, you can actually create your own pools. This I believe is available in other ones that I've seen. Again, not used it too much. Liquidity bootstrapping, I think, is just for ground roots. If somebody wants to get their own token created and they want some help with getting the liquidity kind of started, then they could help with that, I believe, is what that would be. So introducing community-driven yield farming. Some do have something like this where you're able to vote and help sway which ones have bonuses. What that means is when you put into a liquidity pool, there's usually an APY, and sometimes that can get bumped up if voters help vote for a specific one. And sometimes even the DEX themselves, or Vertex in this case, could choose to increase one proactively for themselves to help bring some attention to it and draw liquidity into it. So there's different things they can do to help with that and help kind of decide where we want to invest it and stuff. So the Volta voting escrow system, so the VVertec token, so this is your voting token, and basically by investing in the Vertec WBNB liquidity pool for up to 1 year, you can receive voting rights and do stuff in there. So that is one of the ones I'm going to go into with a little bit. As I see these guys grow, I might kind of DCA into these guys if I feel that they're a good place to put my funds. Time will tell with that a little bit, like with any of these, and you have to be careful with them because, again, there's things called impermanent loss, which we'll look into a little bit to give you a little idea. I understand it. I don't know if I explain it as well as I could, but we'll go through it a little bit, and then possibly again on the AMA dig deeper. And a little higher allocation when it comes to something like this because they want to incentivize people in it, and up to a little boost for core pools because they're pools that they really want to incentivize. They give higher yields in them, and then a voting power by using this one. And perpetual trading, so some trading options. I'm not going to get into too much of this or the NFTs yet because, as I said, that information will be coming down the pipes. And other than that, that's basically kind of it. And as I said, again, not a bad idea to go through the white paper a little bit to get some more details, and then we'll go to the website. I do want to quickly stop on here. This might look a little scary. This was when they launched, I believe. Yeah, so keep in mind, lots of launches, this is the way they go. It is what it is. We're fighting over such little money inside DeFi. People are just either that you've got your non-believers that kind of just jump in to play the coin, play the token or whatever, and that is what it is. The nice thing is, though, it seems to have stabilized for quite a few days now. I'm assuming because of the way the liquidity's gone, we're not going to see a whole lot of big dump. So, I mean, again, there is a downward trajectory, but hoping with marketing and a few other things, we've had some green here a little bit, that we'll see some opportunities for it to go. So again, do at your own risk, but I think there's some value here. I think there's some excitement. I do know they are doing a lot of marketing as well as doing some things on Twitter to try and garnish some awareness. And the team, like I said, some partnerships that are quite good, like up and different ones to kind of help bring people into their deck. So keep an eye on that. And again, don't get in if you're concerned about this. You can watch me if you want follow-ups on how I'm doing with this. I'm very happy to do that for you if you're curious about where they're going and how it's going. And as I said, I've got a few videos coming out with them over the next little bit to hopefully help garnish some awareness again as well. Because like I said, I do like the devs and stuff, and they seem like good people. I've been introduced to them by people I trust, which I do like when my network kind of works like that. There's people that just shill me stuff, and then others where there's definitely some more thought process and trusted people that I know are not going to shill me just anything. So lots of things up here to look at. Obviously, the swap is one thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the swap right now because I do need a portion of tokens, of Vertec tokens, in order to get into the ones that I'm going to get into. And I wanted to show you this. So one thing I don't think people realize when they're doing things is it's really good to pay attention to things like this. I think a lot of people come in here and just move things around blindly because maybe they don't take the time to understand what's going on. So if you notice, if I trade BNB for Vertec because of the liquidity sizes and stuff, I get a price impact of 0.32. And I'm going to put it actually up to, because I'm going to need 500. Oh, no, actually, sorry. I need $500. So we're going to bump that up almost twice. Let's go 800. Sorry, I should have found this out beforehand. 5, look at that, working our way up, 6, there we go. So we're going to say 56 to get us around that $500 mark. So if you notice, price impact is 1.25, a little larger because Vertec probably doesn't have a ton of tokens, so I'm going to change the price of this token by buying some quite quickly. And it looks like it's going possibly up a little bit, so I need a little bit more, but we'll play around with that. So something like BUSD, if we were going here, you can play around with this. Notice the price impact has gone, actually, no, that's because of the count. So let's go with 500. So price impact is even higher, right? Because I need more tokens. So just something to keep in mind when you're doing trades. It depends on where you're doing them and what you're doing. But price impact can be quite a large thing to change your stuff. Right now, I'm dealing with a low cap token. That's why the price impact is being so affected. So we do have to be careful with that because my dollar's not going as far. In this case, I'm going to accept it. And I know that it's an issue because it's such a smaller token right now. So my $500 is not going to go as far for that reason. But I believe my $500 will go better because of this number being larger if I do BNB right now instead. So I think I said, what did I say, 680? No, more than that. Oh. Was it 780? Oh, the price is moving around a bit. Might be going up right now. 800? What are we doing? 850. Oh, it was 8. Yeah, it was 800. Yeah, there we go. 856, 7. There we go. So we're going to review the swap. I need to unlock my ledger. So sorry, that was a little funny. But as you can see, it's 1.25. So it's a better value than if I was to do it through BUSD. So that's why I kind of switched that up. So let's review swap. And this is, I found this one really fast. I was doing some other swaps because I got a little bit of other tokens already set up. So this video didn't take too long. And pretty impressed. So I have to enter it. I accept. So I've just accepted. And it actually shows you how the transactions are going and where the blocks are that they're happening. So it's kind of cool. And done. Super fast. Like that was faster than you see on MetaMask or on a lot of other swaps where I do them. I feel like, I mean, minorly, seconds, whatever. And it tells you how it goes about them and what kind of trades it's doing to get you to that point. Which is funny because why wouldn't have. So it's using the liquidity pools to create your transactions and stuff. So anyways, kind of neat little background there. You get to see how the smart routing's going and how it's creating it and stuff. So now what we're going to do is do some earn. So the rest of the stuff, not all of it's really available yet. I don't believe the staking is available as of yet. Yeah, because you can't. Yeah, not started yet. These are coming and these will allow you to earn money on just staking the base token, the VRTX token. So what you'll do here is when you earn by investing in these pools, some of them are going to give you back the token. So they're going to give you rewards in this the Vertec token. And then when you take that Vertec token, as you earn it, you can then bring it over here later and stake it in these pools, and they will give you rewards. You can buy your own token and buy and just put it in there, but you can also earn it so that you're earning inside the ecosystem and then perpetuating yourself even more rewards over time. So it's just something to keep in mind. Then if you were to get these the other tokens, which I'll show you in a minute, you'll be able to get voting rights, and then you can help create percentage increases to the pools by putting your votes in there and allowing for more opportunities. And then in here is where you'll claim your Vertec and your voting tokens based on what you invest in and the places where you invest it. And then the NFT marketplace, as we said, coming soon, the perpetuals coming soon, and then there is, looks like a bridge coming soon. You can already use the bridge. So there we go. And something here to note is obviously bridges are really neat things, but you do need to be careful with them. So let's say we're moving, I don't know, let's do that, USDC. Just gonna do this for a second and show you. Bridges are hard to find. So if I'm sending BUSD over there, it looks like it's pretty good fees. So sometimes I can get them as low as like 25 cents, but that's a rare case sometimes depending on how much you're moving. But that doesn't look too bad at all. The fact that it's under a dollar is possible, worth maybe giving this a try as a bridge for yourself. So I'm glad I took a little peek at that. So it depends on where you're going, and these numbers will change drastically. But just keeping in mind when you're doing bridges is just to keep an eye on what you end up with after you've done your bridge. And I would test that, but I just don't have a need right now, but maybe I'll test it later. And if anybody has any questions, let me know to see how fast it was and the cost and stuff. So again, but if you needed to bridge some tokens, I might give this a whirl because like I said, it looks pretty good based on my quick analysis. So let's create some pools. So your main one here that I wanted to start with is the Vivertech Vincent, which is your main one. And this one gives you, like I said, those voting tokens that you need in order to help other things. So this is one of your base ones. Basically, the idea behind this is creating liquidity for the Vertech token so that trading it is not as volatile. So with this one, you're going to click invest. There is a fee for this one, so do keep that in mind. And you're going to invest proportionately. So I'm putting in, I don't want to put in the whole amount, but I'm assuming I'm going to click this. Apologize, I'm doing, there we go. So we're going to be able to then, so this one here, I'm going to put $250 into. So hopefully we'll be able to total that up. Oh yeah, it's going to be proportionate. So too many things. I just sort of had a little spreadsheet for myself. So this one's the main one that we're going to do. So we're going to put, and it's 80%. So let me just take a look for a second. Sorry, I just noticed at the bottom, my total is actually coming up there. So I'm going to put 225 in here. So we'll get as close as we can. There we go. So this will calculate. So price impact looks like it's not being affected. Oh, and well, I guess I'll do preview probably. Potential weekly yield is $43. So let me see how that means. This is your projected weekly yield based on the last 24 hours of APR. So yeah, the one thing to keep in mind with these is when you put funds into them, there's a certain yield that's kind of projected right at that moment. But as more and more people put money in here, that can change quite drastically because the fees and stuff that are being shared with the pool become spread over a larger amount. So if there's 100,000 in here or 500,000 in here, obviously the rewards I'm going to get based on my percentage of the pool will change on that. So if I'm holding $250 in here and there's only $1,000, I'm going to get a lot of rewards if of all the transactions that happen. But if there's $1 million in here, I'm going to get very little of the pool. So keep that in mind that your yields can change. So something that looks really amazing right now may not turn out to be later on and stuff. So we got 250. We're gonna hit preview and approve. So I think because it's on their decks, that's where the price impact doesn't happen here. And I'm not really buying any tokens. I'm just moving tokens into the pool. So and that was the one with BNB. Yeah, so we got that. And we're gonna go approve. I don't know if I ended up with enough of tokens that I needed, but I'll play around with that afterwards. Sorry, darn thing keeps going down. Okay, so max. No, I don't want max. Well, it doesn't matter because I'm going to be using them all anyways. So I'm just going to put max in because that approves them all on my ledger, so they don't have to prove them later. Pardon me. And approving. So now we're gonna have $240, $220. I meant to do 250. Damn it! Oh well, I did what I did. Messing up my own thing. Problem when you do things live or on camera. I guess I'm not technically live. So we're putting $224 in there. If everything goes well, I hopefully will end up with $42. But as I said, that'll fluctuate up and down. So there we go. Return to pool. So you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go ahead and go back in, and I'm gonna do another 25. Because I do want to kind of keep this to the 1K because it'll be easier to kind of see as it goes up and down. And I might put together a spreadsheet. So 225, there we go. Let's get to see my mistakes as I make them. All right, except on here. But really smooth here. I do like the way the system works. It seems to be really optimized because a lot of times some of this stuff takes a little bit more time. And there we go. So now I should have, I don't know if it'll show me the exact dollar amount, but so volume swap fees. I think I'll see the pools when I go to the other spot. Oh, there we go. My investment. So there we go. So 226 plus the 25. So I got my 250 in here and we should be good to go. 251. There we go. And my APR right now. So as you can see, it's pretty nice high APR. Obviously that can change, but for now, we'll have some fun with it. The issue with this too, though, is obviously if it's really high and I'm getting, now this one I'm getting the governance token, so I'm not sure how that will all work and I'll play around with that later, but so we'll see what happens there and we'll go from there. All right, so let's go back to earn. And you can even go to the home too, because it shows kind of your base ones. So the feature ones are the ones they're kind of directing you to. I need to talk about that a little bit. It's kind of done on purpose, and it's usually not bad for the investor as well. So as you can see, this Three Amigos one I'm going to go into as well, which has the Vertec token again, but has Bitcoin and ETH. And I'm looking forward to seeing, because the returns are pretty decent there right now. And the Buddy system I'm doing as well. The Buddy system, and again, in the Vertec one, the one thing I didn't get into here, because the weighting's so high on this side, and this one here is 50-50, you do have to be careful of what's called impermanent loss. And what that means is if this token value goes down, it needs to keep the same weighting. So then it has to buy more of it with this one, and vice versa. So when there's volatility on one but not on the other, it can create some problems with impermanent loss. I'm hoping, because of the marketing they're doing and the other kind of things, it'll help bring them both up, kind of thing. But when you have a stable coin on one side, it does help protect against that within reason, but not perfect. This is why I say I know about this stuff, but I don't know if I explain it as well as I could. So I appreciate you holding on for this, and hopefully it goes. So as you can see with this one, and that's what I should have showed you before as well, is this one here is 80% the VRT, the Vertec token, and 20% the BNB one. Whereas this one here is 50-50. So again, we're gonna invest in this one, and we're gonna invest proportionately. And again, we're going to do 250 in this one, and actually get to the 250 this time, or around there. I don't know. I should have both of those, but just in case, so I don't have enough for the last one, I'll do that. Preview. Approve BUSD. And that one, I'll just do 250, because that's what I'm putting in. No, actually, what am I thinking? Putting 125. 2603, it says right there. Right there it says it. Next. Approve. And then on my ledger. Voila. And the last one, I'm going to put 500 in there. Because it's Bitcoin and Ethereum, long term, there hopefully could be some good forward motion with it. And technically, it could drag the price of the Vertec token up, as they both appreciate when you're inside there, which is kind of the reason for that. So I'm going to put the bigger amount in there. And it's got some pretty good rewards right now. So return to pool. And there we go. Now we got 253 in there. And we're all ready to go, and back over to Earn, or Home, like I said, and we're going to do the Three Amigos. I like the way they name them. It's fine. So invest. So this one, obviously, we're doing three of them, and so I have proportionally the same amount of money there. That's why I'm careful when you're doing it, and then I am low, and I have enough there. So I'm going to have some Vertec left over. That's fine. I miscalculated, I guess. So we're going to go to 500. Am I thinking of, is there a different weight? Oh, huh, my bad. Okay, so see, this is me learning as I go. So right now I don't have enough. So in order to get it to what I want, let's go to halfway, just for calculations. So I need 210 Vertex, so I need 420 total. So let's just go over to swap. And right now I have that. So quick, silly math. I said I needed 420 minus 314. So I need 106 of these guys. 106. So I might end up with a little more than money than I thought. Let's review swap. It's a lower price impact because we're doing less amount. Sorry, this is a little messier than I'm used to. As I said, these are a little bit new to me. I haven't played around with them too much. And so as you can see, there's some things for you to learn as you want to make sure that you're actually looking at the proportions and making your spreadsheet accordingly. So let's close that down. And let's head back to Earn, or just make it easier. We'll go here and invest. Invest proportionately. And there we go, 504.32. So there we go, pretty close to what I wanted in the end. Why is it not letting me? Oh. Why can't I get that to 100%? Or 11. Okay, so it's a little bit finicky. All right, either way, we'll do 98%. There we go. So this is obviously going to go through a few steps because of all the tokens. So we've got to prove the Weath. And we're going to do max, because that's fine. It's only off by a little bit. Sorry, bear with me here. So this one will be a little bit longer. I'll try and maybe put some chapters in here, I guess, just to go through the pools or something. But I appreciate you sticking around. So something a little different anyways than my usual videos. And as I said, I'm looking forward to actually doing the next one and then possibly and then doing our AMA with them just to get into a little bit more details as to how everything works and maybe be able to pick their brain. If you do keep your eye open for that one, I think it's a good one to learn the system, even if you're not investing in this one, but just to learn about these in general is a good idea. So do, if you can, come on by and hang with me for that AMA. I'll try and announce it when I can, possibly with a little short too, to perk your interest again when that happens. As you can see, lots of transactions here. And hopefully learn about how these work. Because I think they're important investment tools, especially when you want to, when we start kind of vamping up and getting ready for the bull run again. Having some stuff in here and growing over time could be quite advantageous for anybody's portfolio. Return to pool. So there we are. So now we've got, as we said, we've got our regular swap, the stake hopefully coming soon. The big thing here is the claim. And so I'm presuming, do I have to, is there a place to pull? No gauge. So I guess I have to wait a bit because I haven't really done a whole lot. Actually, the claiming might be from the stakes, actually, come to think of it. So earn. Let's go back into here. Let's go into my investments. There we go. Three Amigos Buddy System. So it's organized that way, I guess. TVL. All right, need to learn a little bit, but we'll take a look at it another time because I don't want this to go on any too long, but you can always go in here and see my stats and you can see my APR, my liquidity, and my earnings. So we'll have to take a peek there on the next one. Maybe we'll do a quick update of where everything's going on here, and then we'll get into the NFTs at the next video, and then, like I said, the AMA after that. So thanks for putting up with me through this one. I apologize, might be a little long, but have yourselves a fantastic day, and hit that like on your way out if you didn't already, and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next video. I will be doing my update on my wallet challenge there very soon, so we'll see that one coming out hopefully in the next day or two. I'll probably record it tonight if I can. So thanks, guys. Have a good one.